Hi everyone, this is Vamsi Krishna. In this session, we are going to do an end-to-end assignment, or you can call this as a production scenario of deploying Express Node.js application on Kubernetes. What we are going to do end-to-end is, we are going to write a Kubernetes manifest to expose Node.js server with the following configuration. There should be 10 replicas running all the time. If you want, you can change the replicas count. It's up to you. For this, I'm trying to do with 10 replicas. And whatever the Kubernetes deployment we are doing should automatically scale at average 50% CPU and 60% memory. Meaning, we should have a horizontal pod scaler, which will start looking at CPU and memory. And whenever it reaches 50% CPU and 60% memory, it should create the pods automatically. And then we should use custom Docker image, which is hosted on ECR. For suppose we are using Node.js for this particular scenario, you should have Node.js Docker file written and it has to be pushed to ECR for various versions. Or it can be with latest as well. When we are doing, we will do with version 1 and version 2. And then we will log into ECR and pull the image, and we will expose the deployment via service type load balancer. And whenever we change any deployment, we should ensure that 7 replicas are running all the time. At some point of time, what I will do is, once I deploy version 1 and expose the version 1 service and have metric server and horizontal pod scaler, I'll try to change the deployment for the next version, version 2. While doing that deployment, we should make sure there should be at least 7 replicas running all the time. With this, we will get started with the session end to end. Let me go back to the server which I have with me and show the softwares which I already have. I created a Amazon Linux 2 instance. Here I have NPM installed already. NPM is nothing but Node Package Manager. And I have Git installed, and I have Docker as well, and AWS configure, EKS cluster, all these were set up already. Git is for getting the code from the GitHub, and NPM is for building the Node.js application. If you want to run without Docker, if you are running with Docker, no need of NPM as well, because we are going to write a Docker file, and using that Docker file, we will write the Docker instructions to build the Docker image. And then you need AWS configure to connect to EKS cluster. Okay. We'll start with getting the code from GitHub and we'll build the artifacts for Node.js. Git clone, you can go to my repository, Vamsi Tech Tutorials. Under that, I have a repository for Kubernetes. You can clone this Kubernetes repository. Once you clone this Kubernetes repository, I have kept a Docker file already inside that. Before that, you can just say npm install. Go into the Kubernetes project, Node.js Kubernetes, and you can say npm install for building the artifacts for Node.js. Once you do npm install, it will create a file called packages-log.json, and at the same time it will create a folder called node_modules. Now I have already written a Docker file for this. Let me show you the Docker file as well. You can say vi Docker file. This is the Docker file. These are the instructions for the Docker file. I have mentioned total 7 instructions. These are nothing but the Docker layers. Whenever we do Docker build, it will start building all these layers one by one. The first one is from, which is equivalent to Docker pull. The second one is work directory. And the third one is copying the package.json and package-log.json. And the fourth one is running npm install. And the fifth one is copying all the artifacts. And the sixth one is exposing the port number. And the seventh one is running node server.js file. In the server.js file, I have written a sample response where we will get hello world version 1. We can write response dot send. Currently it is hello world. We can say hello world version 1 and save this file, because we are building it for version 1. We can do control L so that it will go to tab first and we can see the full screen. Okay, now we have the Docker file ready. Let us start executing Docker build command. But before that, we need to create a repository in Amazon ECR and log into ECR, and then we can start creating the Docker image. Go to services, Amazon ECR. You can create a new repository. Click on create repository. Mention the repository name as Node.js-Kubernetes. You can keep any name. For my convenient purpose, I am keeping this. Create repository and click on that repository, and there are some view push commands you can do one by one. I am not using this login command because it is just giving me login password. Instead, I have some command with me which I can login directly. Okay, first let me use AWS ECR get login, and it says login succeeded. That means I was able to log into Amazon ECR successfully. Now we'll start building the Docker images. We will use Docker build command hyphen t for a tag, and we will mention it as version 1. We need to wait until this gets finished, and then we can see Docker images. Now all the 7 steps were done. Now we can see Docker images. If you see, we have a new repository and image ID. Now we need to tag this repository with Amazon ECR repository. Go to Amazon ECR and copy the tag command. It was with latest. Let us change it to version 1. Now the tag is done. Now we need to push the same. Change the latest to v1. Now we are pushing the Docker image repository, whatever we tagged, into Amazon ECR. Now we can go to Amazon ECR console and we can see whether this image is being pushed there or not. Once this is done, we can do that. Okay, we can go to Amazon ECR. Close this pop-up and just refresh it. We can have the image. Now if you see, we have the image tag v1 and the image URI is there. We need to copy the image URI and we need to replace this in Node.js deployment file for the Kubernetes deployment. If you see in the code, I have kept Node.js deployment YAML as well. You can say vi Node.js deployment dot YAML file here. When you are doing, you need to replace your image. This is my image. You need to replace it with your image URI. And then if you see, I have mentioned couple of other parameters as well, like liveliness probe, readiness probe, and then I have mentioned the replicas count as well. If you see in the spec, I mentioned replicas as 10. So that whenever we run this deployment, we will have 10 pods running. And the strategy type is rolling update. Why? Because I am trying to do rolling update for updating it to version 2, which we will see later. For now, you can assume this kind is deployment and we have 10 replicas. And in the spec containers, I am using the image URI, which we just created sometime before. And the container port, I am exposing it on 8080. and liveliness probe and readiness probe is just to start our pods when the containers are ready. For this purpose, we are using liveliness probe and readiness probe. This what readiness probe will do is, this readiness probe to decide when the container is available for accepting traffic, and it is used to control which pods are used as backends for a service. Or this is the purpose of readiness probe. And liveliness probe is nothing but when should we restart a container. That is the purpose of liveliness probe. And I have mentioned CPU and memory as well for this. Let us save this file and run the YAML file for deploying this application. Kubectl apply-f, you can mention the YAML file. Node.js-deployment.yml. Now the application is deployed. Now we can see the deployments. Now we can see the deployments, kubectl get deployments. We have the deployment and we can see the pods as well. This is the deployment name, and parallelly we can see the pods which were created for this deployment, kubectl get pods. If you see, there are 10 pods because I mentioned the replicas as 10. That's why we have 10 pods running. Next thing what we are going to do is, we are going to expose this deployment as a service type load balancer, so that we can access this application from outside world with load balancer URL. For that, I have written a service YAML. We can see Node.js-service YAML. Here, if you see, the target port is 8080, and that target port output, I am redirecting it to 3000 for Elastic Load Balancer port. And if you see, the kind is service, API version is V1, and metadata is Node.js web application, and spec type is load balancer. So that whenever we run this YAML file, we will get external IP as load balancer URL. Let us save this file and run the command kubectl apply. Now the service is created. We can see the service using kubectl get service. Now the service is created, and in the external IP we got the load balancer. We can go to Amazon EC2 console and we can see the load balancer, whether that is in service or not. We need to wait until it becomes in service, and then we can copy the DNS name and hit from browser. Go to the instances and see whether the instances status is in service or out of service. As of now, the service is out of service. We need to wait for some time to come it into in service. Still they are out of service. Now one came in service. Now at least we can start accessing the application. Now go to the description and copy the DNS name, which is nothing but alias record, and hit that URL from the browser. We should get the response hello world version 1, which I have mentioned some time back. If you see, hello world version 1 is there. Now next thing what I'm going to do is, I want to create something called metric server. On the metric server, once the metric server is there, I want to create horizontal pod scaling, where I will mention the CPU and memory utilization percentages. Go to the metric server, and in the metric server we have a couple of files like API service, deployment, resource reader, you can execute all these files at once using kubectl apply-f store. All these were executed. Now we have the metric server. If you want, you can see from the namespace as well. We can use kubectl command so that we can see whether this metric server is coming or not. Kubectl get all should display everything. If you see, we have service pod and deployment replica set. This metric server will be there in the default namespace. We'll try to give namespace. Okay, metric server may be there in different namespace. Let me go to kube-system. Okay, if you see, we have the pods under metric server under the kube system namespace. These are all the services for metric server. That means we have the metric server pods also up and running. Now we can go to our folder and try to create horizontal pod scaler, because when I'm discussing about the design, I mentioned we need to scale the application by both memory and CPU. For that we can use horizontal pod scaler. This horizontal pod autoscaler we will use to mention both CPU and memory. Let us execute this YAML file as well. kubectl-f node.js-hpl. Okay, we have the horizontal pod autoscaler also ready. We can see that using kubectl get hpl. Targets it is saying unknown. We'll wait for some time, it will show the targets. If you see, currently we have mentioned, if you go back to YML file of Node.js HPA, let me open that file again. We have set 50% CPU utilization and memory utilization as 60%. And we can open one more tab and we can see both at once also. I mentioned target average utilization is 50 for CPU and target average utilization is 60 for memory. But whatever the horizontal pod scaler we created, it is not reaching the target as of now, which is fine. Now what we can do is we can try to change the code and we will build one more image for version 2, and then we can do the rolling update of that so that the previous pods which are running with version 1 should run with version 2 after this change. Go back to server.js file. In the server.js, change the response from hello world version 1 to hello world version 2. Now build the Docker repository again using Docker build command. Here you need to mention V2. We have the version 2 image also ready. Now we will tag this and we will try to push it to ECR. we have tagged it. Now we will try to push it. Now we have pushed it. Now we will see both version 1 and version 2 images are there. And we will try to do the V2 is also there. Now we will try to do rolling update deployment so that it will use the version 2. Open the deployment file. Again, Node.js-deployment.yml. Here, change the Docker image to run it on version 2. As the strategy type is already rolling update, this will stop the previous pods which are running. It will delete the containers and it will restart the containers with version 2 images. You can watch the parts also, what is happening exactly. Now you can say kubectl apply hyphen f. Again, the Node.js deployment file. Node.js deployment YAML file. Now if you see, it is saying configured. You can see in the other tab, container is getting created and couple went to pending. But if you observe, already there were a couple of pods running parallelly. In between, if somebody access our application, let us go back and access our load balancer URL. In between, if somebody tries to access our application, still they will get the response version 1 until version 2 is active. We need to wait until all comes into running state. Then if we access the load balancer URL, we will get the response from version 2. This is nothing but rolling update. Now you can see the pods. Still couple were in terminating state, few are in running state, most of them are about to finish their execution. Now 4 were in terminating state, remaining are fine. Once this is done, we can start accessing the application. I think we are good in almost it is done. Okay, now everything is running state. Now let us access the load balancer URL. We should get version 2. If you see, we got the version 2. That means whatever the rolling update deployment we have done is successful. But in production, if by any chance, if the deployment we have done is a failure, we should be able to roll back to the previous deployment. For that, we need to do rollback. In this case, hello world version 2 response is fine. In case anything wrong happens on production, and if we want to roll out our deployment, whatever we have done to the previous revision, we need to use the rollback steps. For that, first you need to see the rollout history, and then you need to mention which one you want to point to. Okay, you can just execute the command kubectl rollout history for the deployment. Okay, these are the revisions. Revision 1 and revision 2. Now you want to point it to revision 1. That's why you need to undo the current deployment. you can say you can do undo deployment to revision one. Now we have successfully rolled back the deployment from version 2 to version 1. Again, if you see the pods, same few will be terminated and few will be pointing to the previous one. In that way, we can roll out to version 1. We'll wait until everything comes under running state, and then we will access the load balancer URL so that it should get the response for version 1. Okay, now all are in running state. We'll go back to the load balancer URL and access. We need to get version 1 response. Okay, if you see, we got version 1 response. That means rollout also happened successfully. And finally, if you want to tear down whatever you have created, basically you can execute all the delete steps for all the YML files you have done. You can say kubectl get service first and then deployment, and you can delete one by one. Start deleting the service using kubectl delete the service name. You can say kubectl delete service name. The service is deleted. In the same way, you can delete deployment, kubectl delete deployment name. And we can delete horizontal pod autoscaler, kubectl get HPA, and we can delete horizontal pod autoscaler as well. And if you want, you can delete metric server related things as well, but overall this should be fine. This is all manual. We will do all these steps in a automated way as well. But for now, we have done successfully a deployment and exposing the service and doing a rolling update to version 2. And in case of any failures, how to roll back to version 1 using rollback also we have done successfully. Thanks for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel.